aviation enthusiasts, and welcome back to another Teaching Tuesday. I'm excited to be back with you all. The other day I was talking to a friend of mine, and he asked me the question. He said, hey, once you get your pilot's license, what can you do to advance your career? I mean, how do you get that first job in aviation? And I thought, that is a great question. He's like, you know what? You should do, and he's been watching some of my YouTube videos. He lives in the neighborhood here, and he said, you should do a video talking about what kind of jobs you can do once you get your pilot's license. He's like, you should make that a Teaching Tuesday video. And I said, you know what? I might just do that. And here I am. So anyway, the very first job I got, once I got my license, so first of all, I got my private pilot's license, which allowed me to fly around and enjoy the wonderful thing that we call aviation and the privileges that come along with that certificate. And then I went ahead and progressed through, which is a normal progression to go ahead and get your IFR. You don't have to, but you're gonna have a very limited commercial license if you don't. So the next step is usually getting your IFR rating, which is what I did. And then I got my commercial certificate. Okay, and with that, you've got just about you have to have a minimum of 250 hours. Some people end up with 275, 300, somewhere in that mark. But you're not a very marketable pilot at that point. You're not gonna be jetting off to an airline anytime soon unless you have a restricted ATP. You have to have a minimum of 1,500 hours to get your airline transport pilot's license to be able to fly some of the larger aircraft and to progress in your career. And 1,500 is a lot of time and a lot of money worth of flying. So how do you get that first pilot job? So the first job I got once I got my commercial certificate, I was fortunate enough to live up in the Upper Peninsula of Michigan, and I actually started working for the Department of Natural Resources, the DNR. And they had me doing survey work and some fire watch, watching the area during the summer to make sure that we could see any wildfires popping up and report it, zone in on the location. If there was a fire, we could fly overhead and kind of direct the fire patrol and let them know kind of what the winds are doing, what kind of situation we have going on, and then also animal survey. So we had the neat opportunity to track. We'd actually have like trackers on some of the wolves and some of the moose. There's actually moose in the Upper Peninsula, not very many. They're a dwindling population, but they're trying to get that population back. And we would track them via the airplane to kind of watch their movements and record that data and then take it back to the people that do all that information and everything else. So it was actually a pretty exciting first pilot job. I had the opportunity to do that because their normal pilot actually lost his medical for a while and they needed me to be the official pilot while he got his medical situation figured out, which thankfully he did and continued on with his career. And that was my first job getting actually paid to fly an airplane. Eventually I went ahead and continued on and got my flight instructor rating, which is actually one of the most popular ways to build time to advance in your career as a pilot. It's being a flight instructor. So basically, you get your private pilots, you get your IFR, you get your commercial, and then you get your flight instructor certificate, and you can teach other people how to fly. And as you're teaching other people, you're building valuable experience, you're gaining more knowledge, because you never quite understand something until you have to completely teach it. To that level, I believe that is one of the best ways, because you're improving your own skills and you're learning every time you're up there with the student. But then also, it's a kind of a unique and cool way to give back to the aviation community, being able to teach other people, and I find it a rewarding experience even to this day. So I would highly recommend somebody who's looking to build time, don't look at it as I'm trying to build time, look at it as, hey, this is a unique opportunity. Yes, I have an end goal that I'm going for, but don't be so rushed towards that end goal that you forget to live in that moment of, this is pretty neat experience that I'm in right now. And so flight instructing obviously is one of the popular ones. I won't belabor that. I've got several other ones that I want to hit on. So moving right along, we'll have a whole video just on flight instructing probably somewhere down the line there. But another very popular one would be cargo. So you might be flying in a 206 or a Caravan, and you're kind of like a feeder route to some of the larger cargo companies out there. And a lot of times they'll hire a little bit lower time pilots to fly some of those smaller routes. So that's an option. Another one, which is a neat one that's based out of the airport that I am flight instructed out of, and which is just north of my house, is banner towing. So a lot of times companies, I don't know if you've ever been to the beach or maybe at a ball game and you saw an airplane flying over, and you saw a big old banner like Geico or some other thing, insurance company or some other advertisement, and those pilots are getting paid to fly that banner around and around, lots of hours of low and slow flying, but it's a very unique experience. If you've ever gone out to the airport and watched how they capture that, it's kind of neat to watch. So that's another option. Another option is aerial survey. So surveying the area from the air, and a lot of companies will hire you to do that. You have special camera and equipment on board and GPS, and you're able to do that. And a lot of times they'll hire a little bit lower time pilots for that. Also, pipeline and power line. If you've ever seen some of the lower airplanes, they're flying along what looks to be like a track or a power line, or they're checking for leaks maybe in a gas line that goes through an area, or looking to make sure that no branches or bushes and stuff like that are starting to encroach too much onto a power line that's going through, and they're will hire you to do that. So that's another good job for a pilot. Also, skydiving. You can get paid to take up a load of skydivers and fly them all the way up to altitude. You kick out all of them. They go diving out of the sky, jumping out of a perfectly good airplane. And then you just fly that airplane back down and take another load up. And it could be a little bit hot, a little bit tedious, and a little bit crazy because you got people jumping in and out of your airplane. But I've heard some pilots that have really enjoyed it and find it pretty rewarding to work with all of the jumpers and everything. They're a unique crowd of people, so it's a lot of fun if you're into that. Another one is air tours, and I did a little bit of this at our flight school. We did flight instructing, but then we also did tours of Chicago back in the day. I don't think we do that as much anymore, but we used to do that. And other places like the Grand Canyon, or perhaps out over out in LA along the shoreline there, anywhere where there's some really nice natural beauty, there's usually an opportunity to gain some hours as a commercial pilot doing some tours of the area. And it's always kind of fun because it's usually either non-aviators or people that are really excited to catch the views and really be wild. So it's a lot of a reward as the pilot just to see people just so enamored and excited about the experience. They're not bored by it, and it's a lot of fun that way. Another opportunity that a lot of pilots have is being a ferry pilot. Some people actually choose to do this for their career because there is some decent money in it, and they might actually do this all the way up into some of the higher levels. But just starting out, you might get a chance to ferry. Maybe somebody buys an airplane, maybe they're not certified in it, or they don't want to take it all the way across the country. They buy it in New York and they want it flown to California. They'll pay a pilot just to fly it from point A to point B for them. After that, you jump on an airline and fly home, and you charge them for that segment of the time. You get to time build, you get some pretty neat experiences in, you might get to fly some unique aircraft, and then also ultimately you're getting more time and experience in an airplane, which is the goal, right? The next thing along the line is flying private. Maybe I had a friend that I knew when I was going through my flight instructor ratings, a pilot, actually a lawyer, bought an airplane, was not a pilot himself, and actually hired him as a pilot just to fly him around to where he needed. So you could fly a private aircraft, whether that's a Cessna 182 or 206, or any type of maybe a light twin, even a 310 or a Baron or something along those lines, and you could get paid just to fly a private person around. It might not be all that often, but it might even supplement some of your other flying that you have going on. A lot of those jobs won't be a salary till you get into some of the larger aircraft. And then also you can start doing, even as you gain more experience, opportunities open up to fly like what's called 135. So you're doing a little bit of corporate flying, maybe in a King Air, maybe in a CJ, a smaller jet, maybe even in a some other type like a Pilatus or something along those lines, maybe even in a Caravan or something like that. So these are all opportunities for you to grow and build, and some of these things that I've mentioned actually might even turn into, you might like it so much and enjoy it so much, it might turn into a lifelong career for you. But those are just some of those jobs that are starter positions to build your time so that you can either A, go off to the airline, or B, if you decide to go into a line flying for like cargo for the rest of your life, as far as like at the FedEx level or at UPS or so on and so forth, or if you decide to stay in the corporate world of aviation, flying private jets, all of these type of jobs will be stepping stones along the way to really help you to expand your knowledge, to grow, to gain those crucial first paid hours, and it's pretty unique experience. I tell this often to the CFI applicants especially, and it goes for a lot of the different aviation jobs, but it's a pretty neat experience, and even to this day, I'll look out the window sometimes and just be like, wow, I get paid to do this. It's pretty awesome. You can't complain. But a lot of times, as I was just starting out as a flight instructor, you know, you're sitting in a Cessna 150, it's hot, it's sweaty, or it's freezing cold, you know, 10 below zero, and you're out there by the airplane trying to get it started, and it's the engine doesn't want to warm up, you pulled it out of the hangar and it still doesn't want to fire, and you're warming it up and it can be frustrating, or you're on a hot summer day and you've done like, it feels like 100 landings that day up and down, and that student's just not getting it, and you're hot and you're sweaty. But at the end of the day, you just have to sit there as you're cruising along, look out the window and go, wow, the office view is not that bad, and I'm actually getting paid to do this. And it's a pretty awesome experience. Yes, it's a long journey perhaps. Yes, there's a lot of work along the way, but definitely the destination is worth it. And I think the journey itself is a big part of what aviators love about flying and about being part of the aviation community. Hopefully this has helped you kind of gain a little bit of knowledge about kind of the process and what different opportunities are out there, even for low-time pilots. Don't worry, you don't have to pay for the full 1,500 hours out of your own pocket. There's a lot of different options out there. Another one, just as I'm going, if you don't want to do any of those things, I've heard of some people even buying their own airplane, maybe partnering with another person and just fly and racking up their hours that way. I'm all for having your own airplane. I've owned a Cessna 150, I've owned a Cessna 172, I've had a Cessna 206. I plan to eventually own another aircraft again. I have good friends that allow me the use of their aircraft, and I enjoy that immensely, just flying separate from work even. But I do think that if you're gonna have a career in aviation, it is smart to not just go around and fly around in circles, racking it up on your own time. Some of these other jobs are gonna put you in situations and give you experiences that'll give you such valuable knowledge and life experience that you're definitely gonna want along the way. Hopefully you've enjoyed this video. If you have, make sure to smash that thumbs up, subscribe, definitely leave a comment below. I love hearing from you guys. If you have any questions regarding the content that we just talked about or anything else you'd like to know about in aviation, I'd be glad to help you if I can. And remember, keep learning, keep sharing, and the top thing that every pilot should always keep at the forefront, fly the airplane. Aviate, navigate, communicate. We'll see you on the next Teaching Tuesday.